Time now for an in-depth look at the market news this afternoon, and for that I'm joined on the line by Dr. Yang Jun-sok, Professor of Economics at the Catholic University of Korea. Professor Yang, thank you for making time today.
Happy to be here.
Well, stocks in New York were down overnight. Positive vaccine news outweighed by the surge in coronavirus cases in the U.S. The S&P down by more than 1%. The Nasdaq down about 0.8%. What's the story in the global markets?
Okay, well, as you just mentioned, the U.S. markets were down. Dow also went down by 1.16%. And U.S. press, U.S. newspapers are blaming coronavirus. The coronavirus relief bill is going nowhere. The Congress and President Trump is not doing anything much. And President Trump is still not accepting the fact that he lost. So the uncertainty there is growing. And then in New York City, because they had a infection rate of higher than 3%, their schools are closing. And that seemed to be affecting the markets as well, since most of these exchange changes are in New York. And the New York Fed president, John Williams, has said that the U.S. is still in recession. So the press is stating that the stock market has fallen because of these factors. But on the other hand, if you look at the European markets, they basically see the same news. Now, coronavirus in Europe is getting slightly better, but still, there's nothing substantially different, but the European markets were up. So it seems to me that rather than representing just slight difference in how people feel about the coronavirus, it does seem like the market is sort of meandering, and any slight bit of news, good or bad, is seems to have outsized effect. Now, the Asian market has been more mixed. Nikkei has gone down by 0.36%, and Hang Seng, the Hong Kong index, has gone down by 0.50%. Nikkei has gone down because Tokyo is now on high alert for, almost at the high alert for coronavirus. Hong Kong, there has been a lot of international criticism for cracking down on legislative council members. So that accounts for the negative movement on the Nikkei and the Hang Seng. But Shanghai does seem to have risen somewhat by 0.47% at least so far during the day.
Well, here in Korea, the KOSPI was down most of the day but ended just barely higher. Retail investors, foreigners were buying today on both main indexes, institutions selling. What happened in the local markets?
Okay, well, as you just mentioned, the KOSPI eked out a positive at the end of the day, so they rose by 0.07%. But we have to remember, KOSPI is only about 2% from its historical high, which was in January 29th, 2018, at 2598.19. So there may be a reluctance to buy too much since, well, the historical high does act as a sort of a psychological barrier if there's really not that much good news. On the other hand, the individual investors do seem to be preparing to buy more if there's a positive trend upwards. The cash deposits to be used for stock purchases by individuals are at a historical high at 65.1 trillion won, near historical highs, I should say. And the just a few days ago, it was lower by 10 trillion won, just at the beginning of November. So the amount of money that the individual investors are ready to spend at the stock market is at or near historical highs. Problem is, because KOSPI is near such historical high, I think people are being very careful. Now, KOSDAQ market, it rose by 0.96%, and again, there, individuals and foreigners bought today.
Now, the exchange rate's come down so much in the past several weeks as the dollar weakened. The exchange rate is back up today, though, a bit, to around 11.14, 11.15. What do you make of these moves, Professor, and what's your outlook?
Okay, well, the usual trend when the global economy is getting more stable is that the U.S. dollar gets weaker and the other currencies become stronger, especially the yuan seemed to have gotten stronger in the last few days, and that has induced Korean won to rise as well, since the popular opinion now is that Korean won tends to follow the Chinese yuan instead of the U.S. dollar. But the changes today, which resulted in a fall from yesterday's 1133.6 to 11.03.88 yesterday to today, does seem to lie with the government's warning. The government has sent warnings that the exchange rate seemed to be strengthening too quickly, so they did send some warning that they want the exchange rate to not rise as much, and that seemed to have had a big effect today. Now, it's not entirely clear right now if there has been actual purchases by the government or the Bank of Korea today, but it seems that the jawboning by the government authorities has worked, at least for today.
Got it. All right, Professor, we have to leave it there for today. Thanks so much for sharing your insights.
Thank you.